everybody behind him. Danny Smith seems to have taken a hold of second place. But there's Mudford into the fence on the inside of the track. An awful crash on the 61. And four cars into a Bobby Davis Jr. also involved.
Also, it is number 23, Greg Woolley, Chris Eash, number 17, E is involved in this thing. And as far as Mike Ward was concerned, the tag he took on the inside wall wasn't that bad. He came across the racetrack. It was getting T-boned that has done the severe damage. This is a serious, serious accident.
Oh, it absolutely is, Steve. Mike Ward tumbled down the front straightaway, upside down a couple of times before being tagged by Bobby Davis Jr. And, of course, the Davis crews, there are more cars upside down in the foreground. We can identify the 2H or Rich Kubek, otherwise we can't tell who's involved.
Now watch the fifth car in this picture. He comes down and hits Mike Ward. That forces Mike to the left. He takes a brutal shot on the inside retaining wall, but now his troubles really begin. Hard to believe a 1,250-pound car could get this high in the air. The wing is of no use here because he never really gets upside down. Now you'll see, coming into the picture, the number 10 car, Bobby Davis Jr. He could not possibly avoid Mike Ward. When Davis got on the brakes, he was rear-ended by the red 29 car. You see on the left, that is Jim Bowden. But there was more damage than just that quartet. Mike Ward continued to take a beating.
He's the one that was hit the hardest and the one we're most concerned about at this particular moment, he and Bobby Jr. Let's take one more look at it as we watch Ward tumbling down the front straightaway toward turn number one. This cluster of cars coming right in behind him. There is the 29 car getting up on top of the 10 car of Bobby Davis Jr. That's Jim Bowden. And once more impacted is the 61 car of Mike Ward. And finally, Chris Eash in the 17E crashes into the whole lot. A really rugged collision. And let's hope everybody walks away all right. Notice, too, on the left side of your screen that four other cars are also tangled up. That's Bubeck, Kenny Conrad, Greg Hodden, and Greg Woolley. They are not as seriously damaged. Now, here is an extraordinary view of this crash. Here is Bobby Davis Jr. trying to slow down and is hit from the rear by Jim Bowden. Terrific.